were even on welfare, and they were worse off than we were. I can remember that Mama would tell us, don't go outside eating something if you don't have enough to share. And if you did go outside eating an apple or an orange, some kid would say, dibs on the core, dibs on the peel. Mm. They were very hungry.
Was your mom really careful to make things last?
Oh, my goodness. We saved everything. As a matter of fact, there was no money for shampoo, and so Mama would take the little pieces of soap that would be left in the soap dish and put them in a jar with water until the soap dissolved, and that's what we used for shampoo. When we were lucky enough to have oranges, they would be wrapped in orange paper, like a tissue paper, and we saved the wrapping paper off of the oranges, folded them, and put them in a little box on the tank of the toilet. So I guess you know what those were for.
That's such a delicate way of describing it, Jean.
Did I do it well?
Yes, you did. You did indeed. Hmm. It's been such a pleasure to talk to you. Thanks for sharing the stories and the memories with us.
Oh, thank you.
Jean Rutherford Duane grew up in Georgetown. In 2009, she shared her reflections on life in the Great Depression, which began on this day in 1929. Jean has since passed away. And this Colorado Matters special continues after a break.
Thanks for the stories.
I'm Ryan Warner. You're with CPR News.